welcome. Language is a vital tool for communication. It is not only a means of communicating thoughts and ideas, but it also builds friendship, economic relationships, and cultural ties. Festivals promote diversity. They bring neighbors in dialogue. They increase creativity. They provide opportunity. They improve our psychological well-being. In short, they make cities a better place to live. Mother India Public School carries Virtual Lingua Fest, the festival of English, to refine and rebuild the better character. Myself, Bhagya Subin, and with most pleasure, I'm inviting all the students, teachers, and parents to this great festival of English, the Lingua Fest of Mother India Public School, Kallara.
Strength when I am weak, you are the treasure that I seek, you are my only known. Seeking you as a precious jewel, Lord, to give up I'd be a fool. You are my only known. Taking my sin, my cross, my shame, rising again I bless your name. You are my only known. When I am down you pick me up, when I am dry you fill my cup. You are my only known. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my only known. Seeking you as a precious jewel, Lord, to give up I'd be a fool. You are my only known. Taking my sin, my cross, my shame, rising again I bless your name. You are my only known. When I am down, you pick me up. When I am dry, you fill my cup. You are my only known. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God,
English Fest. With the concept of English Fest, we are aiming to make people aware about the importance of the language of English. Today's English Fest will be filled with programs based on the wise usage of English. The language of English has been regarded as the first global lingua franca. It has become the most important language in various fields. We use it as an international language in communication and in many fields ranging from business to entertainment. The language of English opens an ocean of career opportunities to those who can speak and understand the language anywhere in the world. Similarly, it has become an inevitable requirement for various fields like medicine, computing, and more. With a fast evolving world, it is essential to have a common language which we can understand to make best use of ideas and information available. As a result, the language of English has become a storehouse of various knowledge ranging from social to political fields. Today, about 400 million people use English as their second language. Thus, being the most common second language in the world, it is beneficial to learn English to open doors to new opportunities. Now, I am thanking all our English teachers, Ashwati ma'am, Thanya ma'am, Charlie ma'am, and Dagi ma'am, for providing us with the knowledge of English.
Let us now welcome the man who does not need an introduction, are known among all of us for his wisdom and his knowledge, none other than our honorable principal, Trivandrum sir.
Very good morning. We know that English Festival is a program to encourage and reward skills in using the language among students. English First promotes quality English skills such as speaking, reading, writing, and listening in children of all levels. If you look at the importance of the language, it is the only international language with which one can speak to any countries of the world. It is one of the most widely spoken language in the world and taught in more than 120 countries, and is commonly used around the world as a trade language and also a diplomatic language. It is also the language of science, aviation, computers, diplomacy, even tourism. Moreover, English being the most commonly used language in the corporate world, and knowledge of English is one of the most important employability skills. I myself have traveled to more than 70 countries in the world and experienced the importance of the language. As a UN diplomat, I have never found any difficulty in communicating even with the unskilled laborers of the industries and the chemical production world. As because every human being in any part of the world has little knowledge about English. And I promise you that you will very well survive in any part of the world if you have the basic skill in the language, and that is English. And this is the reason why Mother India Public School, Kallara in Trivandrum district, is seriously thinking of bringing the English language skills in our children, even from the foundation level. Holding English First will familiarize the students with modern English learning techniques like ASL, that is the assessment of speaking and learning, introduced by CBSE as part of the subject adjustment in the subject, and also facilitate interactive language teaching experiences in the schools. This year also, Mother India Public School is conducting competitions in English Fest online in this pandemic situation for students, category-wise. It is proposed to include events like spelling marathon, phonics, oral English, words smith, like smartness in handwriting and dialogue presentation, giving importance to words, listening comprehension, caption writing, newspaper quiz, debate, extempore, fun with English, mock interview, and even making English short film. And thank you all.
Hello all, I'm Madhana Srijit from 10th Standard. Today I'm going to say the details and program list of English Fest. As you all know, due to the existing pandemic, we cannot perform pair or group items. Instead, we are mainly focusing on individual items. So, let's move on to the program list. For category B, standard 1 and 2, we are having action song, be a character, and puppet show. For category 1, standard 3 and 4, we are having puppet show, news reading, cookery show, and storytelling. For category 2, standard 5, 6, and 7, there is puppet show, news reading, cookery show, and product launch. Now, at last, category 3, standard 8, 9, and 10, there is skit, mock interview, news reading, and anchoring. Now, moving on to the program details. Action song. Action songs are songs with movement for miming and role playing the words and the language structure. Storytelling. Storytelling is an act of sharing tales or a series of events. Puppet show. Puppet show is usually a dramatic performance staged with the puppets with dialogues or music. Be a character. For example, acting like a teacher, doctor, etc. News reading. Acting like reading news from a television or radio. Product launch. Acting like launching a product like an advertisement. Angering, acting like an anchor in a show. Mock interview, acting like an interviewer who is asking questions to a celebrity or like a celebrity who is answering the questions of the interviewer. Cookery show, in it we have to present a food preparation. Skit, which is a short informal performance intended to educate or inform something. Thank you.
We are from Mother India, singing Molly Molly during on the stage. Now we are on our English fest, singing Molly Molly during on the stage. Now love, ha ha, once more, kiss kiss, all together once again. Ha ha, kiss kiss, now we are on our English fest, singing Molly Molly during on the stage. Lingua Franca.
I'm Nakshatra, student of class 7, is here to present a puppet show based on the moral, truth is always the best.
Once, Tara was playing with her dad's watch. Suddenly, it broke in. Oh, dad's watch, what shall I do now? Tara. Oh, dad's coming. Let me hide. Tara? How are you, dear? I'm fine, dad. I want to go out immediately. So, where's my watch? I don't know, dad. I don't know. Okay, let me check here. Here? No, dad, it will be not here. It will be there in your room. No, it's not there. I have already checked there. Okay, dad. Oh, what I'm seeing? My watch is broken? Tara, did you break it? No, dad, I haven't break it. Okay, so you don't know how it break. No, dad, I don't know. Okay, Tara. After some times. Dad, are you upset with me? No, dear. Dad, then let's play games together. I'm so bored. Yes, we can play true or false game. True or false game? Yes. Whatever I say, you want to tell it true or false. Are you ready? Yes, ready. Let's start. I caught the rainbow. No, dad. Impossible. False. Tara studied today. Yes, I did it. True. Tara ate an apple. Yes, true. I did it. Yum, yum. I rode a shark. False, impossible, dad. Tara break my watch. Yes, true. Oh no. So you break my watch. But why did you lie to me? Sorry, dad, I broke your watch. I'm so scared because you will scold me. Look, Tara, I will never scold you. We parents want our children to be honest. That's the most precious gift to us. Your problem is you're always scared. Be brave and tell the truth. And my Tara is very brave, isn't it? Yes, dad. Look. You want to tell everything bravely, isn't okay? Yes, dad. I will always be brave and tell the truth. Oh, my dear. Dad, when you were little, have you ever lied? Yes, Tara, I had lied. You know what my parents taught to me? What? They taught me an important thing. A lie will never let you rest, but the truth is always the best. What does it mean, Dad? Telling the truth may seem difficult for the first time. But once a truth make the way ahead very easy. And lying may seem easy in the beginning, but it creates many problems afterwards. you have to tell many lies to cover up the first lie. Yes, Dad, once I lied to you about breaking the watch, I had to lie again and again about other things too, and I wasn't feeling good after lying to you. And how did you feel now after telling the truth? I feel nicer and lighter. Oh, my dear. Hope you guys understand that truth is always the best.
Hello all, welcome to today's chat show. Today we are having a gifted writer in our show. She is an Indian writer who made a unique position in the field of English literature. Here we have Mrs. Anita Desai. Welcome, ma'am. How did you discover you were a writer?
From a very young age, I knew that this was what I wanted to do. Before I could even spell, I was putting the letters together to make words. My family would see me sitting in a corner, scribbling all the time. So they used to address me as the writer.
What were you reading at that time?
In my early years, I was influenced by British classics of Virginia Woolf, H.G. Lawrence and Thomas Hardy. But as I progressed, I discovered many Russian authors too.
How was your teaching experience?
It has always been a bizarre for me. I never taught before I came to US and I never thought I would. I needed to eat at that moment in my life. I taught modern Indian literature in translation and courses in creative writing.
You have written many types of books. Is there any area that you regret or haven't tried?
One does what one can with one's life. I have tried to make the fullest use of what I had, and I hope I have succeeded to an extent.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you for spending your valuable time with us. Thank you so much.
Of human nature to be scared and to feel fear. When I was in Sweat Valley, there were times when I was scared. I was scared to go to school, but what kept me going was courage. It came to me because of the way my father inspired me, speaking out for women's rights and girls' education. When I travel to a country and I know that being there will raise awareness of the girls' issues who live there are facing. Perfection. Happiness doesn't mean having fun every day. Martin Luther King and Gandhiji are my teachers and my real heroes. When I go to university, I feel just like a student. I think it just reminds you that you're still 20, 21, and you are still a student. It's a good time. Now I have become their friend, so I do feel that. But oftentimes, if you are at the airport or somewhere in the market, then people will sometimes stop you and ask for a photo or ask you to sign something. Well, I think men have to do a lot of work. My father is an inspiration because his 5 sisters could not go to school. Believe in your voice, believe in yourself, and always follow your dreams. Because especially young girls, they dream big, but as they grow older, they start underestimating themselves. They do not believe in themselves. They do not dream big. So I would ask all the young girls to dream big as you can and just follow your dreams and you can do anything. Going through all these situations in my life, I have learned that now, surviving that attack, this life is for a purpose, and that is for the education of children. It's only 70, 80 years that we live, and why not leave it for a good purpose? Why not leave it for a service that can help humanity? It's a pleasure for me to answer all these amazing questions.
Thank you. Isaac Asimov was born on January 2, 1920. He is an American author and a biochemist. He is also a highly successful and prolific writer of the science fiction and of science books for the layperson. He wrote or edited about 500 books. He is also known for his works for science fiction and popular science. He died on 6 April 1992. One of his most popular science fictional stories is The Fun They Had. He wrote this story as a personal favor for a friend. The main theme of this short story, The Fun They Had, is that of education. The story deals with the future of education, which will become computerized and estranged from social interactions. Today, as students of class 10th are trying to do a small role play on this chapter, The Fun They Had. Due to the COVID-19 situation, it's not so easy for us to do so, but we are trying our level best to do. I hope you all will enjoy it. Let's start.
Margie even wrote about it that night in her diary. On the page headed 70th May 2157, she wrote, "Today, Tommy found a real book. It was a very old book. Margie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all stories were printed on paper. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awfully funny to read the words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on a screen, you know. And then, when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had when they read it first time."
Gee, what a waste. When you finish this book, you just throw it away, I guess. Our television screen must have a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away.
Same with mine. Where did you find it?
In my house, in the attic.
What's it about?
School.
School? What's there to write about school? I hate school.
Margie always hated school, but now she hated it more than ever. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography, and she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully for the county inspector.
The county inspector came to inspect Margie's mechanical teacher. He smiled at Margie and gave her an apple. Then the county inspector took the teacher apart. Margie had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again, but he knew how, all right, and after an hour or so, there was it again, large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all lessons were shown and the questions were asked. The part Margie hated most was the slot where she had to put the homework and test papers. She always had to write them out in a punch code they made her learn when she was 6 years old, and the mechanical teacher calculated the marks in no time.
"It's not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quick. Those things happen sometime. I have slowed it to an average 10-year level. Actually, the overall pattern of her mark is quite satisfactory."
Margie was disappointed. She had been hoping they would take the teacher away altogether. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because the history sector had blanked out completely.
"Why would anyone write about school?"
"Because it's not our kind of school, stupid. This is the old kind of school that they had hundreds of years ago."
"Well, I don't know what kind of school they had all that time ago. Anyway, they had a teacher."
"Sure, they had a teacher, but it wasn't a regular teacher. It was a man."
"A man? How could a man be a teacher?"
"Well, he just told the boys and girls, gave them homework and asked them questions."
"A man isn't smart enough."
"Sure, he is. My father knows as much as my teacher. He knows almost as much, I betcha."
"I wouldn't want a strange man in my house to teach me."
"You didn't know much, Margie. The teachers didn't live in their house. They had a special building where all the kids went there."
"And all the kids learned the same thing?"
"Sure, if they were the same age."
"But my mother says a teacher has to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and girl it teaches, and that each kid had to be taught differently."
"Just the same, they didn't do it that way. If you don't like it, you don't want to read the book."
"I didn't say I didn't like it."
"Margie, school?"
"Not yet, Mama."
"Now? And it's probably time for Tommy too."
"Can I read the book some more with you after school?"
Maybe.
Margie went into the school room. The mechanical teacher was waiting for her.
Today's arithmetic lesson is on addition of proper fractions. Please insert yesterday's homework in the proper slot.
She was thinking about the old schools they had when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy. All the kids from the whole neighborhood came, laughing and shouting in the schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom, going home together at the end of the day,
and playing together different games.
They learned the same thing, so they could help one another in the homework and talk about it.
The mechanical teacher was flashing on.
When we add fractions one way to
Margie was thinking about how the kids must have loved in the old days. She was thinking about the fun they had.
Good morning, one other person here. My name is Shiga L.A. Today with me, we have a melodious guest.
Hi, I'm Shreya Goshal.
So, welcome to our show, ma'am.
Thank you.
What was the first thing coming in your mind when you hearing the theme of Kerala?
Now, Kerala is synonym to music for me, of course. Kerala is known for its beauty. I mean, I'm the fan of, you know, the beautiful places, mountains and the greenery of Kerala.
Okay, ma'am. What do you think that Shreya Ghoshal is a story or a song?
I think I'm a song because songs have soul, so I am all soul.
Can you sing a song for us?
Oh, yes. Mujhko hira de de, kasmere va de de. Meri tu vaavon ke ishaara ko sahare de, dil ko thikane de, naye bahare de, aavon ki baarishon ko mausam ke sivaare de, apne karam ki karadai, kharge ki taraf hi tu nitaai, sun raha hai na tu. रो रहा हूँ मैं सुन रहा है ना तू क्यों रो रहा हूँ मैं.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I like this song very much.
Thank you.
People definitely think that you are a Malayali singer when you are singing. Are you a professionalist?
Oh, yes, I am. I have compulsion of fixing something over and over again.
Okay, ma'am. Do you remember how many songs you sang in total?
No, I don't live in past or future, just live in present.
Okay, ma'am. You did not dream your future?
No, not at all.
What is a 16-year-old Shreya Ghoshal's dream?
I definitely did not have time to dream because I have already started living on my dream.
How would you like to call the journey as bright 2002 to 2021?
Absolutely amazing. I mean, every step of our journey has been very special for me.
Anyway, thank you so much for spending your valuable time with me.
Thank you.
It was really nice meeting with you. Thank you.
Thank you.
So the ingredients are egg, powdered sugar, maida, milk, sunflower oil, baking powder, vinegar, baking soda.
So first step is to take 4 4 eggs and separate it as egg yolk and white.
So I have separated the egg yolk and white. Now take the egg yolk and add 1 teaspoon vanilla essence to it and mix it well. Add it. Then mix it. Then keep it aside.
Then take this egg white and mix it well until it becomes a fluffy material mixture.
Now look at it become a fluffy mixture.
Then add 1 cup powdered sugar to it and mix it well. Now take this egg yolk and pour to this mixture and mix it well. Next take 1 cup maida and add 1 teaspoon baking powder to it. Then mix it. So now add this egg mixture with the maida and baking powder mixture. Then take 1/2 cup milk and add to it 1/2 cup sunflower oil. And mix the milk mixture with the egg mixture.
Then we get our glitterz-like mixture. Now take 1 teaspoon vinegar and add 1 teaspoon baking soda to it. Then add the vinegar mixture to this egg mixture. Now our batter is ready. Then take a vessel and preheat it. Now take a butter paper and place it in the vessel in which you are going to heat our batter. And pour the batter to it. Now it's ready to heat. Then avoid the bubbles by just knocking it. Now you can decorate this cake as your wish. Now it's time for heating. Then place it like this and heat it in low flame. Close it with a lid tightly and heat it for 40 minutes. Cake is ready.
Our tasty and delicious cake is ready. You can serve it with your family and enjoy. Hope you all like this video very much. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.
Dignitaries and the most valued parents, the bold sun is dawning in the tranquility, the twinkling stars in the dark blue evening sky are announcing the arrival of the great evening. To develop the ability in every individual to cultivate the creativity, to foster their autonomy and develop a feeling to society is the main aim of this Ahodhya's Language Fest. So, by keeping this in our own mind, let us start another language fest, casting the talent of many children. So get ready to enjoy the glory of the event. The colorful dances, action songs of our children are just gonna dazzle you. So, it's our proud privilege to have a guest of honor, a man who is known to bring innovative changes in the teaching techniques, Dr. Prem Bhatnagar, along with our chairman. So please welcome all our dignitaries with a huge round of applause. So, ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, a true prayer is a spiritual transaction between the heaven and the earth. So, I request all of you to rise up for a prayer song. Prayer is aligning ourselves with the purpose of God. So now, I invite our principal sir to give a small introduction about the chief guest. So now, the moment has come, the most awaiting moment. Yeah, the colorful and fascinating performance of all our students. So let's enjoy. Wow, it was really fascinating performance. So now, for the time being, we have to conclude our fest right here. So, I invite our respected principal sir to have a conclusion speech. Thank you, sir. It was really an awesome speech, right? Now, I'm once again thanking you all for spending your precious time with us and creating this function as a great success. Thank you.
Wonder Woman.
say that you have to keep working hard and hard. Work is key to the success. There is no excuse for it. And the most important thing is they need to be dedicated and focused. They need to have a goal, goal to support. That is the most important thing. And another most important thing is parents, parent support. And that is the most important thing for me. My parents have been very supportive. They were always behind me. I was good at studies. Yes, after 10th, I was in regular for sure. Because I had to travel when I was not a badminton player and all. So when I had to become like so famous, I was very much interested for in becoming a doctor. But I now feel okay. Badminton is much better for them. No. Well, I am foodie that time, but I when it becomes to diet, I have to reduce my weight now. So I still reduce my because it is very important for me and is for me. So I have to play now. So I have to keep myself fit. So when it comes to junk food, I will have all sorts of it. I will not eat ice creams, biryani, like the chocolates. No, I can't eat because. Thank you.
Good afternoon, you're watching BB Television and I'm Bhagya Subin. Let's have a look at today's headlines. COVID positivity rate is over 10% in 44 districts of the country, says Health Ministry. India reported 30,000 new COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours. The hill states of North India saw the maximum rise in fresh cases during the week ended Sunday as compared with the previous 7 days. PM Narendra Modi to invite Olympic players to Red Fort on August 15, also to interact with them at his residence. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will invite India's Olympic participants to the Red Fort as special guest on August 15, when he will deliver his 8th State Independence Day speech. Official sources said Modi will also invite them to his residence for interaction. CBSE Class 10th Results 2021 declared. CBSE 10th Results 2021 has been announced by the Central Board of Secondary Education on Tuesday, which recorded a passing percentage of 99.4%. Farm unions prepare to take on BJP in the political arena. In the hinterland, farm unions are preparing to resist agricultural policies of Narendra Modi-led government. The protests have continued after they began in November 2020 from Punjab to Haryana and Rajasthan and most importantly Uttar Pradesh. Congress MP gives adjournment motion notice in Lok Sabha on Pegasus project report. Let's check the weather report. It's probably a good weather in India for the last few weeks. It's mostly sunny today. That's all for today's bulletin. Thank you for watching.
WhatsApp rolls out disappearing photos and videos, features to take on Snapchat.
Colonchi may help in treatment for COVID and the injections. Study. Climate change could devastate emperor and penguins. CBSE 10 results yet again. Girls score points of boys. Mirabai Chanu dedicates Olympics medal to India. Sindhu wins bronze, becomes first Indian woman to win two medals at game. India has most billionaires after US, China, Mumbai, 10th wealthiest globally. Sports news. Neeraj qualifies for javelin throw final. Japan's Uzasome wins battle of the teens for skateboarding gold. Dahia ensures medal for India. Wrestlers becomes only second from country in a title clash as he storms into final with sensual pin down. That's all for today's bulletin. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.
Hello everyone. This is the new Oppo Bluetooth speaker 2.4. This is very durable and buying this is value for your money. This has two powerful set of speakers inside this, and so the sound quality of the speaker is fantastic. This has four modes: USB mode, AUX mode, Bluetooth mode and FM mode. And when we plug the USB or AUX, it automatically activates the mode, and we can only use these modes when the AUX or USB are connected. So when we switch on the speaker, it says a voice with the mode on which we are.
Bluetooth mode.
And if we change to FM mode, it will say FM mode.
Bluetooth
and we again to go to Bluetooth mode, we'll say Bluetooth mode. But I have mentioned earlier, we can only use FM mode and Bluetooth mode at this moment. Because when we can only use the other modes, which are the AUX mode and the USB mode, when the USB or AUX is connected. So I beg you that if you buy this and use it at your home, you will be surprised by the durability, the quality and the value for money for this product.
Welcome to E-Living News. News headlines, education news. Meghalaya Board of School Education has declared the 10th Glitterz 2021 at August 5 at 11 a.m. The registration process of CAT exam has started. It will be held on November 28 in 158 cities. State news. Maharashtra reports 6,126 new COVID cases. Districts remain alert. Sports news. India hockey ends 41-year medal weight with a bronze in Tokyo. Boxer Lavlina Borgohain became the third Indian athlete at the Indian Olympic after the weightlifter Meera Bharchanu and shuttler PV Sindhu to clinch a medal, bronze. National news. Sports strategist Prashant Kishore gave as advisor to Punjab Chief Minister Arindar Singh on Thursday, stating that he had decided to take a temporary break from an active role in public life. Under national news. NASA should lead human space flight to billionaire adventurers such as Jeff Bezos and Elon Musk, a top astronomer said. News and details. Martin Rees, the UK's astronomer royal, said AI technology made human beings increasingly redundant for scientific missions. But he said the world should be celebrating the crazy adventurers who fund their own missions. Meanwhile, SpaceX founder Elon Musk wants to go to Mars and has spoken of 2024 as the earliest possible date for the human flight. And that's it from you and my team in this edition of Evening News. Thank you for watching. Stay home, stay safe.
Welcome to the news headlines. Olympics. India win bronze medal in Tokyo, first time Olympic medal in hockey since 1980. India logs 42,982 new COVID cases. States advised to impose local curbs for festival like Onam. UAE to let in Indian nationals with president visa from today. Riders apply. Revised COVID illness. Health minister also insists on vaccination or RT-PCR certificates for entering shops. Tokyo, Devikumar beats Nurislam Sangirev to enter Olympic final. News in details. Olympics. India win bronze medal in Tokyo, first time Olympic medal in hockey since 1980. India's men hockey team have won the bronze medal in Tokyo after defeating Germany 4-1-4. India logs 42,982 new COVID cases. State advised to impose local curfew for the festival like Onam. India added 42,982 new coronavirus infections in a single day, taking total tally of COVID-19 cases to 3,18,12,114, while the active cases increased to 4,11,070. The UAE will let in Indian holding a resident visa again from the Thursday, August 5, however riders do apply. Devi Dahiya on Wednesday became only the second Indian wrestler to qualify for the gold medal clash at the Olympic Games when he sensationally turned around the 57-kilogram semi-final by Nursalam Sanivev here. So this is the end of the news headlines. Thank you and have a nice day.
Welcome to News Bulletin. I am Vivek. Today's headlines. Revi Dilbar get a good draw. European champion Alex Anchumani. Girls outrun boys by a slender margin of 0.35, while 99.4% students passed class 10 exams, the results of which were declined by CBSE on Tuesday. Natasha Curry, an 11-year-old Indian-American girl, has been judged as one of the brightest students in the world by a top US university for her exceptional performance in SAT and ACT standardized tests. A Manipuri film based on the life of Olympic medalist Mirabai Chanu is all set to be produced. Two spacecraft will fly past either side of Venus next week in the span of just 33 hours. Here is the end of today's news bulletin. Stay home, stay safe, thank you.
Welcome back to 2pm News. News headlines, international news. Northern Afghan city of Kabul taken by Taliban lawmakers. China steps up vaccine outreach with new global push. Indonesia's North Mount erupts with burst of ashes and lava. COVID-19 UK eases the travel restriction for India. National news. COVID vaccination certificate in 3 easy steps. Health Ministry. 50 crore people already vaccinated in the country, says Nirmala Sitharam. PM must intervene to the parliament logjam. Sports news. Olympic hockey medal for India after 41 years. First gold medal for India in the Tokyo Olympics through Neeraj Chopra. Patience Bajrang Punia reaps reward. The stars of India ever Olympics performance. Thank you.
Hey, food is ready. Shall we eat now?
No, dear. I think it's time to rain. I can see huge mountains of cloud approaching.
What about children?
Ask them.
Children, do you need food now?
Not now.
Me too.
They are in raindrops. They are new coins falling from the sky.
The big coins are 10% and the small coins are 5%.
Yes, God willing.
Oh my God, it is getting worse.
Will this affect your harvest?
Maybe.
If it will continue, it will affect our harvest.
Everyone, get in fast.
Oh my God. A plague of locusts would have left more than this. The hail has left nothing. We will have no corn in this year.
We all going hungry.
Where are we going?
For seeking help.
Oh goodness, I am really so stupid. Hey man, look at this.
What?
Is this man mad? Let's show this to the postmaster.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the cooperation.
God, if you don't help me, my family and I will go in hunger this year. I need 100 pesos in order to sow my field again and to live until the crops comes, because the hailstone has destroyed all the crops.
What is your opinion about this letter?
He is a fool. Even children know that this letter won't reach God.
Do people believe in God?
Everyone believe in God. This man is in a crucial situation. We must help him.
Why should we help him?
Everyone believe in God. This man is in a crucial situation. We must help him.
Sir, how should we help him?
In this letter, the man requested for 100 pesos. So, with all our contribution, we can sum up the amount.
But sir, our salary will not match upon this amount. So, how will we?
That's a problem. Let me call my friends, check whether they can help me or not.
Hello, Alex.
Hello, Edward.
Hello, Edward. Okay, I will help you.
Okay, thanks.
I gave 3/4 of my salary, and you all and my friend also gave half of their salary. But this didn't match the 100 pesos.
Enough is enough. We can give the 70 pesos to him in a letter.
So, what will we write in it?
Don't write our name. The man should think the letter is sent by the God. Give this letter to the man when he arrives.
Sir,
here's
a letter for me.
Hey man, there's a letter for him.
Sir,
can I get
a sheet of paper and a stamp?
God, of the money that I asked for, only 70 pesos reached me. Send me the rest, since I need it very much. But don't send it through the mail, because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks.
Good evening to all the wonderful people present here. I welcome you all to the Trivandrum Sahodaya South Zone English Fest 2021. Today is the last and final day of Trivandrum Sahodaya South Zone English Fest 2021. All our competitions are done. Now, we are going to distribute the prizes and we want to know who are the winners of Category 1, 2 and 3 and you want to find which one is the best school of this year. For announcing the results and for the prize distribution, we are having some special guests. So I warmly welcome to the president of Sahodaya Complex, Mr. Muralidharan Nair. So welcome to the event. Now I'm gonna welcome the secretary of Sahodaya Complex, Mrs. Srividya Panikar ma'am. Ma'am, welcome to the show. Now we are having a chief guest for today's event. She is an amazing poet and a fictional writer. It's none other than our very own Miss Meena Kandasamy. Ma'am, welcome to the event. Thank you for taking your valuable time to spend with us. Thank you so much. Now, I would like to start the event with a prayer dance by our young, graceful dancers. Students and dancers, please take the stage. It's yours. Wow, that was a stunning performance. Now, I would like our chief guest, Ms. Meena Kandasamy, to the stage to speak a few words. Ma'am, please. Thank you, ma'am, for your inspirational words. Now, let's now move on to the main agenda of our event, the prize distribution ceremony and the result announcement. The first award is for category 1. I would invite Mr. Muralidharan sir to do the honors. So please. Okay, it's time to announce the winners and we want to give the prizes to the winners. So please announce. Wow, runner-ups are Nirmala Bhavan Higher Secondary School. Congratulations. And now the winners. Winners are St. Mary's High Secondary School. Give them a big round of applause for the great work they have put. Next award is for category 2. And now invite Mrs. Srividya ma'am to do the honors. Ma'am, please. The runner-ups are the Oxford School. Congratulations. Now, what about the winners? The winners are Mother India Public School. Please give them a big round of applause. Congratulations, winners. Now, moving on, the next award is for category 3, for which I cordially invite our chief guest, Ms. Meena ma'am, to do the honors. Ma'am, please. Okay, for the who are the runner-ups, ma'am? The runner-ups are St. Joseph Senior Secondary School. And winners? The winners are Mother India Public School. Let's give them a big round of applause for the great work they have done. Now, we come to the last but not the least award for the event. The award for the best school. I request Ms. Meena ma'am to do the honors. Ma'am, who are the winners? It's none other than Mother India Public School. I heartily congratulate all the winners and participants. You all have done a great job. Keep it up. Now, we have done with all the prize distributions. It's time to end the show. I would like to conclude today's event by thanking Mr. Muralidharan sir and Mrs. Srividya ma'am and our chief guest, Ms. Meena ma'am. I would also take this opportunity to thank the amazing audience. Thank you for your cooperation throughout the event. Thank you so much. It's time to end. But don't worry, I'm looking forward to meet you all next year. Till then, it's me, Adhishree, signing off. Goodbye.
Hi everyone, I'm Afna Shamnad of Class 10. It's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks in this special occasion. First of all, my sincere thanks to Almighty God for making this virtual event a grand success. Now, I'm immensely thankful to all teachers and all people who worked behind the scene to make this event happen. And now, our sincere gratitude towards all parents who support their children and encouraged them. And finally, I'm thankful to all students who made this event joyful with their impressive performance. Once again, my hearty thanks to each one of you. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.